Let's face it, screen recordings don't always go as planned. The good news is, they don't have to. In this tutorial, I'll get into some features that not only minimize the number of re-records, but also make editing a much more efficient process. If you've watched a few of our other tutorials, you may already know how to trim and split media. To review, you can trim media by hovering over one edge until a cursor turns into a double arrow, and then drag it in. What you may not realize, however, is that trimming actually crops the media instead of deleting it. So if you have to backtrack, simply hover over the edge, drag it back out, and voila, your clip is restored. To make a split, select the appropriate clip or clips, place the playhead where you want the split to be, and click this button. You can also use the S hotkey. Splitting allows you to isolate sections of your video or audio for further edits, such as adjusting the clip speed. Sometimes there are long processes that are important, but they don't necessarily need to be seen in real time. See how the only thing that happens here is an upload? It doesn't need to be watched second by second, so we can use clip speed to speed it up. Select the clip, right-click, and then select clip speed. Clicking the arrows will adjust the duration by percentage. You can also tweak it afterward, right on the timeline. Hover over the edge of the green clip speed bar until you see these little arrows, and drag the clip out to slow it down, or in to speed it up. Let's see how it looks sped up. Nice, but now I have a gap on my timeline. While I could bring each piece of media in, it's more efficient to select the first clip, hold shift, and drag. See how it moved the media to the right of the clip? You can also ripple move media across multiple tracks. Say you didn't leave room for a title slide, but you want to add one. All you have to do is move the playhead to the beginning of the project, then hold the shift key while simultaneously dragging it out. Now there's space. Just keep in mind that ripple moves only affect unlocked tracks. Another feature that's useful to know about, should you find you didn't leave enough time in your recording, is extend frame. It essentially duplicates a frame of your choosing, and you can adjust the duration as needed. This is helpful if you need to pause on a particular frame, like a menu or a tooltip. Simply select the clip, place the playhead at the appropriate frame, and then right-click and select Extend Frame. If you prefer hotkeys, you can press the E key. As you can see, a copy of the last frame was added to the end of the clip. The default duration is 1 second, but if you need to adjust it, you can click these arrows, or enter it manually, or drag it on the timeline. If you extend a frame in the middle of a clip, you may need to unstitch it before you can drag it. For more on stitching, be sure to watch our Stitching Essentials tutorial. Well, that wraps up the editing in depth. In the next tutorial, we'll get down to the nitty-gritty of animations. Click here to watch that now. Or click this link to share feedback about this particular tutorial. Thanks for watching.